Well, good morning, everybody. Jeff Slakey here on the Daybreak Show. Spencer Hughes as well. On the phone line is Jan from the Hardware Distillery. Good morning, Jan.
Hi, Jeff. How are you today?
I'm well. Thanks for taking some time to speak with me and us on the phone line here. I was talking with Heidi from the Shelton Mason County Chamber of Commerce the other day, and on their new website, there's a little news note, and it said Hardware Distillery now making hand sanitizers. And I had seen this across the country. Distilleries all around the United States are turning into making hand sanitizers. And I said, well, Hardware Distillery is great. Chuck and Jan are great. Let's get them on the phone and talk about this. So tell us a little bit about, one, first, how you're doing this, and then we'll get into kind of why you decided to do this and a little bit more.
Well, we are, first of all, how we're doing it, we are obtaining stale apple cider from Whitewood Cidery down in Olympia and distilling it to make the sanitizer. And then there's some other ingredients you have to add. And we are making, because we're making it from scratch, we have really small quantities, but we make about 7 gallons a week, and we are making enough. We're trying to give half of it each week to like our local fire departments, EMTs, the food bank, and then sell the rest. And at first we were selling through at the distillery, but now the distillery is closed. And so we are selling them through the grocery store here in Hoodsport and also at the Hamahama Oyster Company. They have a little store at their oyster saloon.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool. I had not heard about it with apple cider before. And so when it comes that way, tell me a little bit about the end product there. And what are some of the other ingredients that that are normally in these sanitizers?
Yeah. Well, first of all, the base ingredient is alcohol in the sanitizer. We were able to obtain some stale apple cider that couldn't be used or wasn't good enough for the company from Whitewood Cidery Company in Olympia. And we've been bringing up big totes of it and distilling it. We're a little bit different from everyone else. Most other distilleries are just using neutral grain spirit, which you can get in huge quantities, and using that as their base. Then the ingredients that you have to add are either glycerol or aloe vera, and also you have to add hydrogen peroxide. So we just mix it up. So we get the apple cider, we distill it, and then once it's all distilled, it has to be up to a certain ABV. It can be between 60 and 80, and ours is at 70% alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
And then add the other ingredients, and then it's ready to be bottled.
Isn't that something? How long does the process take for you?
Well, for us, it takes a while because we have to distill. So it takes about a week. By the time we go down, it takes a day to go down, pick up the stale apple cider, distill it, takes another 3 or 4 days, and then we spend a day bottling, and then we take it over to the grocery store, usually on Friday.
I've talked to you guys over the years, and you guys make your aquavits, your gins, your vodkas, your whiskeys. Did you ever think in a million years you'd be making hand sanitizers?
No, that never occurred to me. No.
Is it something that maybe you keep on your website as a product list as you move past all this?
We could. I don't know if we would or not. I think the big companies are going to catch up pretty soon, and they will be able to make it very, very cheaply again. And so it probably, because of our process, it might not be worth it. On the other hand, because we're making it from scratch, from this apple cider, it has this nice kind of scent of apple cider. I used to hate hand sanitizer, but ours actually doesn't smell that bad.
Did I see that?
Maybe.
Well, we'll keep our eyes open for this. Have another whole new niche market for you guys.
maybe.
Did I see that the FDA loosened some of its requirements, and that kind of is what opened up all the distilleries to be able to even do this?
Yeah, both the TTB, both the FDA and the TTB. So the FDA actually send to the guild, the Distillers Guild of Washington, well, I suppose to all the guilds, but to our Washington State Guild, then sent the form. It looks just like a medical kind of label, and like you'd get on a cold tablet box or something, but it's for hand sanitizer. So we've got that label that we have to put on there. We don't have to go through label approval. They just gave us the label to use.
Mm-hmm.
And then the TTB is not requiring us to pay excise tax on the alcohol we create to put in there. So that's a big saving as well.
Mm. That's really neat and very cool that you, along with the other distilleries in the state and in the country, saw the fact that you may not be making your liquor right now. Although liquor is deemed essential. I mean, it is one of those on that list there. But you guys have looked at what you do and said, listen, we can do some good here and help out by making these sanitizers, which are in such short need for people all across the country. Where can folks find this? You mentioned at the QFC and then at Hamahama. Anywhere else?
Well, it's not a QFC. It's just a local grocery store here in Hoodsport.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So it's at the Hoodsport grocery store and up at Hamahama.
Okay.
And right now we're trying to give half to the nonprofits like the EMTs and fire departments and food banks, and half to sell. So yeah. So that's why we only have two outlets because we just don't have that much.
Well, Jan on the line here with me from the Hardware Distillery talking about the process that they take to make hand sanitizers and another great story to focus on some of the good that's coming out of our community during our this. Now, Jan, I certainly hope that by end of June time, we've moved past all this and we're able to do the paddle across the fjord and crossing and all that, but either way, we'll catch up and check in on you throughout the rest of the spring and into the summer, okay?
Okay, well, thanks. And looking forward to seeing you at the Jordan Crossing and paddle the canal. My fingers are so crossed that we'll open up, or that everything will change just in time to get outside and enjoy that great outdoors.
I hope so. I really hope so. Jan, good to talk with you. Tell Chuck hi for me.
I will. Thanks for calling.
Have a great one.
You too.